yourselves.
Right.
Bloody luck. Another one.
The Alpha!
Take it off, man! You've got this!
Dam unblocked, the voracious Dreki dead, I'd say this jungle is well on its way back to its original glory.
No reason to stop now. There are other dragons in the crater. We should seek them out. What next, then? Should we rescue Birger?
I am ready to drink in the next life.
Over here, the water flows. the water. I never thought we'd bring life back to these parched canyons. We may access more of the crater, but more importantly, life will return. You've done something good today, Kratos.
Yes.
I don't think he's used to receiving compliments, Your Majesty. With the water flowing and new paths open to us, I say we go for a stroll.
We will search, not stroll.
Oh, come off it. You've never enjoyed nature for its own sake? Not just for the treasure you might find?
In fact, some would say the landscape is the treasure.
Yes, some would.
What's it say, brother? Looks like our good deed has already brought back some wildlife, but suppose I spoke too soon.
Another eventide altar. It flew to that structure. There must be a way up.
You mentioned it. There has been one on my mind of late. It goes back to my...
Hold that thought. I think it's about to get violent. Going this way, I believe we'll reach that near Dragon's Lair.
Yes.
Just making sure you know where you're going.
Thank you.
Over there.
Thank you.
isn't you want.
Are you a father?
Yes.
Then you must understand myself, this story. It was for him. Now he's gone. So much chaos and death. I was panicked. Looking for my son. Please, help reunite me with my son and Folkfather.
This father needs his son. We can help him.
What is the last thing you saw, Spirit?
Statues. Two of them. Dragons facing away from each other. Separated like my sons. It will bring me back to him.
This story is like many in this valley. Separated from someone they love by death.
I do not wish a lost son or anyone. Living or dead.
Agreed.
You do? Huh? I assumed you'd say something like, reuniting the dead is pointless.
Not this time.
To get past those vines somehow. Whoa!
Thank you.
can't get through with that bastard trying to bludgeon us.
Then we must
bloody
be
close. Bloody thing can't be hard. Something must be casting a spell on it.
Yeah. You know, back in Jotunheim, I had half a mind to ask Angerboda what exactly her intentions were with the lad. One look at her and any doubts I had melted away.
It's a question every parent must grapple with sooner or later.
I trusted her with my life. I trust her with my son.
You can't argue with that.
Yeah.
another crystal. Best hold on to it until we can figure out what to do with it. Wielded every flavor of power you could imagine. Lightning, fire, the whole lot.
As did I, for many years.
Whoa. Any chance you could recall some of that magic?
No, I have tried.
Magic is bound to the earth. When your homeland dies, your power is puppet. The ogre is near. This may be our last chance to repair.
We fight!
Your opportunistic sword.
It's returned to its perch. Let's pursue it.
You can be with your son now.
Thank you. I can't wait to see his face again. I'll give him this gift and tell him about the brave people who helped me.
Now you can help us. What did you see that day?
I remember walking into a mead hall, and Thor was there.
What was he doing in the mead hall?
There were whispers that he was looking for a Vanir military outpost. I didn't want any trouble, so I got out quick. That's the last I saw of him. But maybe there are others who saw more.
I wonder if Thor was meeting someone at the mead hall.
Faye and Thor sharing a drink?
Faye never drank with me, and she would not have with him.
Sometimes we never really know the ones we love, brother. Unless my eyes deceive me, that seems to be the Stag of Summer.
Is it hot, or is it just my sizzling personality? Nah, it's you, Stag. Can we go already? That's right. We got more food at home. Come on.
I have to say, quite a nice change of pace helping these stags get home. For a moment, I was worried we'd have to kill them.
Yes.
You had a plan to kill it if it had attacked, didn't you?
Yes. Thank you.
So this is where those tracks led.
Drake fed here.
This was my fear. With the drake devouring the wildlife, this land will be barren in a matter of winters.
Some sort of cage.
So it would seem.
Another mystery, Kristoff.
To the left!
Brother, in my travels, I heard of a great battle in your homeland, at a place called the Gates of Fire.
The Hard Gates.
You were there?
No.
Is that regret in your voice?
I did regret not dying there for many years, but no longer.
Brother, I've heard my share of stories about your homeland, but I'd also heard that you once fought in a tournament.
I fought in many contests.
But this particular one, I heard you did battle with beasts, scoundrels, princesses, the undead, automatons, and history's greatest musician. That's not true, is it?
I would not speak of this.
Fair enough, brother. Well, seems like a good time to get back to that story you asked for, brother. One summer, a local laird of renowned eccentricity chose to sequester himself with a small coterie of kinsmen and followers. The aim of their woodland retreat was to achieve enlightenment through study and discipline. They took oaths to brook no distractions until they became wise men.
Distractions?
Aye, women, drink, mostly women. As you can imagine, things deteriorated quickly. By autumn, tempers were frayed and wisdom remained in short supply. One day, I watched as the laird and his brother took their hunt. There they found, at the banks of a river, a lady as fair as any they'd left behind. She pleads for their assistance for fear the currents would carry her off if she tried to cross. The laird doesn't miss a beat. He hoists her onto his shoulders, carries her across, sets her down, doffs his cap, and fords back across to his brother, who is dumbfounded, can't even bring himself to speak. The day stretches on, the laird carries on hunting, and his brother quietly gnashes his teeth down to powder. Finally, the dam breaks. Brother, he cries, how could you do it after everything we've sacrificed? We'll just pick this up later.
Kratos, tell me of an adversary from your homeland. It will serve us well if I understand more of your battle tactics.
There was Medusa, queen of the Gorgons. Her gaze turned men to stone. A mirror would turn her own powers against her. Or, you may remove her head, but that is the hard way.
Which did you choose?
The hard way.
Forget I asked.
Finishing my story from before. The laird had broken his oath by carrying the maiden across the river, and his brother quietly stewed until he could contain himself no more. How could you do it, brother? How could you break your vow like it was nothing, carrying that lass on your shoulders like you were a Shetland pony? The laird just smiles. Brother, I set that lass down across the river. It is you that carries her still. Oh, I got a chuckle. A rare day indeed.
We've returned to the plains. This place is already healing.
Svini went to Helheim, how did he not freeze to death?
A perk of the Jofer.
The boar-shifting warriors of Vanaheim. As wise in statecraft as they are deadly on the battlefield.
So they may shift into whatever form they like.
Sure. So long as the only two shapes they'd like to shift into are human and boar.
Now that the water flows freely, new parts of the crater should be open to us.
Thank you.
Pass open. That dragon is shaking in its scaly boots, I suspect.
Once we approach the dragon, we will kill or be killed. Understood.
More than you know.
Last enemy!
Let's go.
Yeah. I'll say. That ogre's not getting up anytime soon, either.
With the dragon dead, the wildlife will return. Nature has been set to rights.
mother! You're covered in black rot!
Enemy behind you, Kratos!
Nasty hit! All right, brother!
Time to move!
The
Alpha!
Hello, Lady Freya.
Read any good books lately?
Thank you.
Kratos, I see something.
Kratos!
brother. Use it, yeah?